Well, a brand new year. It seems like we were just having a conversation, Holli, but that was a month ago.
I know.
Crazy.
It is. Time's Holli flying Wolfe. By.
Titusville Area Hospital. Who'd you bring in with you this morning?
This is Kelly Clark.
Hi, Kelly. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. Thank you. Welcome.
She is our new marketing and communication specialist at Titusville Area Hospital, so I wanted to bring her on and introduce her and get to know you.
Holli looks calm this morning, so you must be doing a really good job taking some of the pressure off.
Right?
No, I'm just joking. Well, this is exciting. And Holli, you kind of teased us last month and just talking about the growth in your position and mm-hmm. everything that you... What have you been up to in the last month? You've been busy.
I have been busy. The TDU office opened, and we brought Kelly on, and it's been a whirlwind of a month. So,
and that has been amazing over there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the TDU office is busy already. I mean, we had patients scheduled, you know, for the probably 2 weeks before, 2-3 weeks before it opened. You know, we already had patients on the schedule and fairly booked as far as that goes. Of course, we can accept acute appointments, but as far as...
But if they're not cute, then you're not going to...
No, acute.
Okay.
Like...
that rules me out.
Ear infection, something
gotcha,
like that.
Right, right. You're not cute. Get out.
Yeah. Okay. No, we don't discriminate.
Okay. So that's very exciting.
Yes. All right. It is very exciting.
Kelly, tell us a little bit about yourself. Where are you from?
So I'm originally from this area, and I left the area. I was living down in Westmoreland County for the last 20 years, and so now I'm back.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
How'd you get into this profession?
So while I was in Westmoreland County, I was working for a home medical equipment company and worked there for 12 years. Doing medical sales. So, yeah, it was a family-owned business. So working for a community hospital was, you know, a really great move from there.
Very nice. And I'm sure you had all sorts of clients, and they could be cute or not cute, and you would still sell stuff to them. Okay,
excellent. Didn't matter.
Didn't matter, right?
You're not going to let that go,
no.
Are you?
No, it's a stupid joke. I thrive on those, and that's
I know.
That's
I
all
know
I have,
do.
Holli.
I appreciate
that's all
it.
I have.
That's all right.
So, Kelly, this opportunity came up, and you're here, and you're back?
And I'm back.
That's wonderful. So what excites you about this opportunity? What's what makes every day different for you?
Oh, well, that is what excites me about it, because every day is a little bit different. Yeah. You know, marketing, new doctors, new offices, new services that we provide. So it's a little bit of variety in your job. You know, every day is a little bit different. So that's what I like most about it.
Holli, for you, this gives you the opportunity to do what, having somebody like Kelly?
Yeah. Well, it really gives us the opportunity to get out and in the community more because I was not able to do that. I mean, to an extent, you know, we of course participated in lots of different things in the community, but we're definitely going to be able to get out there more. Kelly will be able to go out to the offices and, you know, visit them and just remind them of the services that we have. And I think, you know, they say in marketing you need to be able to touch somebody 7 times or 7 different ways for them to remember what you actually do. So it'll be great to have her. And, you know, even going out to different offices in Spartanburg and Cory, or, you know, just kind of in the area, the physicians that we don't reach as frequently, reach out to as frequently. So it'll be good, especially the specialty physicians, like marketing them. You know, Kelly can let them know that we're doing cardiology and the pain management, orthopedics, and all of those types of things. So
that's wonderful.
Yeah.
And as you're saying, as you expand and you have been doing that, that's going to be really nice to be able to have somebody who can kind of keep up with that.
Absolutely.
Not that you couldn't, because you had 1,000 other things you were also working on, but that's going to be great. And Kelly, for you, that's going to be pretty exciting that, as you said, every day is different and there's some travel with it, but yet, you know, everybody's connected and you get to help connect those folks.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, you've been on the job for how long now?
This is my second week.
Second week. Awesome. Yeah. All right. Should we start grilling her on the specifics of the job yet, Holli, or should we wait?
No.
Just wait.
Wait till next month.
Okay.
No, she's doing a great job. I mean, she's she's did marketing for 12 years and, you know, in the healthcare. So she already knows, you know, the basis of it and, you know, knows print ads, knows all those things.
Sure.
So, you know, it's just learning our services versus, you know, the services that she marketed for before. So, yeah. It's exciting to have her, and we're fortunate.
Well, brand new year, so what does that mean for the hospital? What are you guys looking ahead for? I mean, there's just so much going on. We're you know, only in January.
I know. Well, we are going to be looking at opening the dental soon. That'll be the part on a part-time basis, so I'm really excited about that. It's going to be great for, you know, especially the children, the community. Because there's a lot of providers that don't accept the Medicaid insurance for dental, and that's, of course, what we are going to accept. So it'll be good for those children that they might not have to travel nearly as far. I know Oil City, the Salvation Army, that dentist down there, he accepts that insurance, but from what I understand, they are booked like months out. So,
and am I right in saying that they actually have the location at the school for that, or they did?
No, we're doing it in the hospital.
Oil City did.
Oh, okay. I'm not 100% sure.
Yeah, I was thinking, but the bigger point here is there is a need.
And oh, absolutely.
Kids today, if they have any issues with their teeth, it affects their education.
It affects
their
everything.
Life. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, at one point in time, I mean, having, you know, a dental issue was one of the major things we were seeing in the ER.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that was, of course, before the urgent care. So they're probably going for dental pain to urgent care now. I'm not really sure. But I do know in Meadville as well, when we did the community health needs assessment, one of the highest ranked things for people coming in was dental pain. So, you know, for those kids that need the dentist, you know, we'll be able to see them there now. And it's pretty exciting. So.
Well, that's awesome. So that's something that you guys are going to be looking hard at this year.
Yeah. We're hoping for March. So we're working on, you know, getting the space ready and things like that. So
should people wait before they start calling and getting more information?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, definitely. We're hoping to have something finalized, you know, and we'll start marketing it and getting the information out, and we'll be, you know, sending stuff out through the school and so.
Kelly's like, okay, Mark.
Yeah, dental. Dental's
next. I'm working on that, right?
Yes. Yes. Yeah, so that's exciting. Of course, the ER, I sent you some photos of...
I didn't even recognize the space.
Yeah, it's beautiful. I mean, that's one view of the waiting room, and that area right there previously was x-ray. So that was
x-ray.
Mm-hmm, so that was an x-ray room and the dark room. And of course, you know, we're digital now, so we don't need the dark room space. You know, so it just made sense. It was like a storage closet, and that's the other view of the waiting room. And there's the two bathrooms there, and in the back we have a grief support room. So if, you know, if there's something critical going on with a patient, the physician could take them back in the private room, or the chaplain can, you know, take a family back in there. And so it's kind of nice. That's a registration area. And then in the back of the registration area, we have a triage area as well. So it'll be good. The nurse can take the patient back and, you know, do an assessment on them. And then, you know, they can determine if they need blood work or, you know, what they need to get everything going prior to them seeing the physician. We can hopefully expedite some things. So
looks like it's really opened up.
Oh, yeah.
So
mm-hmm.
You're not just kind of like squeezing into another area to try to register and all that. I mean, it just seems like there's a lot of room now.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's the safest place in the hospital now. We have bulletproof glass and all kinds of stuff.
Wow.
Yes. Yeah, it's kind of...
You're not going to put that in the marketing materials,
No, we don't need that.
No.
But but it's, you know...
That's impressive, though.
Just new standards and things like that.
Sure.
So, yeah, it's interesting how, you know, when we'll look back at what the old ER was and, you know, the new ER, all the changes that will have been made. So.
And again, I'm sure there are moments where it feels like, you know, oh, is it ever going to be done?
Mm-hmm.
But it is amazing just to see the transformation.
Yeah.
What phase are you in right now?
We're in phase two right now.
Okay.
Which that includes the three rooms in the back of the ER that were separated by the curtains. So once this phase is complete, those rooms will, you know, be fully enclosed, have glass doors on them. Wow. So, yeah. So that's that.
Maybe the toughest phase, or
so initially phase two. Phase two is the toughest phase, okay, because we're losing those three rooms to renovate them.
Right.
So we are down a few rooms in the ER, which makes things difficult, but manageable. So, and also part of phase two, we had planned to do the exterior. So they're going to add the overhang in phase two. And now we changed that around a little bit. So that was the other problem, not problem, but difficulty with phase two, is patients would have to come in through the front door during phase two. So because it was the longest phase, and it's in winter, kind of hard to, I mean, of course we're having a really mild winter right now, but we right. changed things around because it'd be difficult to do that phase during the winter months. So we pushed that part of the project out to a different phase later. So we're expecting that to be in June or July that we'll be, completing the overhang and doing the exterior work. And that at that point is when the patients will need to come in through the front doors for the the front lobby to go to the emergency room. Okay. So,
well, it's been quite a couple years of just providing the hospital with a touched up look, and it's been amazing. And I think you've probably gotten a lot of feedback.
Oh yeah,
you know, it's a lot more inviting.
And and it's funny because, like, we've just had comments like, well, we thought it'd be another pat job, or like, we just thought you're going to paint it, or, you know, things like that, because that's really all that's been done for so many years. You know, they would just repaint the wall, and it was a renovation, but it really, you know, it wasn't a right. true renovation. So it's really nice for those people that felt like that's what we were doing. And, you know, we just kept saying, no, we're really renovating the space. So, you know, the staff's really pleased to see, you know, what we've done. And, you know, they're, of course, it's a little stressful because, you know, the restrictions, but they're eager for it to be done, of course, as well.
Sure.
But they're also, you know, they're working through it because they know, you know, what the end result is, and they're really excited for that. So
that's wonderful. You're watching The Morning Drill on Stream Television and on Armstrong's Neighborhood Channel, and listening to it on the Allegheny News Talk Sports Network. Kelly, for you, is it something that you looked at where you said, wow, you know, instead of, you know, things being tough for community hospitals today and you know, larger entities coming in, you have Meadville and Titusville saying, you know what, we're doing a great job. You know, we invest in the community. We're investing back in the hospitals. That's got to be attractive to somebody coming in, I would imagine, and saying, boy, yeah, these guys, they are committed.
Right. Well, I was fortunate enough to sit through some training when I first came on board last week, and it's basically an orientation to kind of get you caught up to speed and what the policies are, things like that. And what 90% of it was saying over and over and over again that, you know, we're here for the patient. We're patient advocates. Patient is the number one reason we're all here. And, you know, that's the number one directive. So after going through all that training, I was like, I'm in the right spot. You know, like it's, it really shows through all of the staff, especially the staff that did the trainings was, you know, that's what's important.
I think the other incredible thing is, yeah, you're right, they look at the patient, but at the same time, it almost sounds like you're hearing less, oh, we have to send you somewhere else for this. Mm-hmm. Oh, we can do that here. We have the facility. We have the equipment to be able to do that here.
Yeah. And that, I mean, that's exciting too. I mean, we are growing in those aspects as well. And, you know, having Dr. Dvorak in here to be able to do, you know, those orthopedic surgeries, and, you know, just that now that we're growing with the pain management and the cardiology, of course we can't, do anything, you know, any type of cardiac surgery or anything like that. However, just, you know, having them here and on board, you know, on our medical staff, that they can, you know, see the patients post-op or, you know, whatever,
sure,
that they can see them in the office here is so nice. You know,
but look at the changes even in remodeling, with the way technology is changing and the equipment improving, and just having access to that, you're designing space to fit around, you know, some of that stuff. So you're able to say, hey, you know what, we can get this machine and we can put it here.
Mm-hmm.
And
Right.
Yeah, yeah, and even on another note, like part of this second phase is a decontamination room, which we never, I mean, they had a decontamination tent, but you have to pop up a tent and then, you know, to decontaminate somebody. But, you know, that so that's going to be...
It's not
technology at all. However, you know, it's just something else that, you know, if somebody comes in and they had, you know, a chemical accident or something like that, they come in through this decontamination room, which they enter from, you know, the outside, they go into that, and then the door takes them to the inside of the emergency room. So they, you know, get all of those chemicals or whatever spill it would have been off of them, you know, before they come into the ER. So it's just, you know, things like that, that, you know, we didn't have before that we're fortunate to be able to add now.
Yeah, that's wonderful. So it sounds like, again, setting up for another big, exciting year at the hospital.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Kelly, for you, I know you're kind of getting everything together here. how much of it is just kind of figuring out what's been done and working with Holli and others to gather information to start putting your expertise into it?
Right. So I think there's going to be a lot of opportunity, mostly because Holly's plate's pretty full. Yeah. So, you know, already she's given me some
projects.
Yeah. Some projects to do.
She said she got a night's sleep last month. Yeah. So that was...
Right. One. Yeah, that's fine. That's good. She gets one.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I just think there's going to be a lot of opportunity. And since she does need help, I think I'm going to be able to put my own creativity in and my own experience and kind of... you know, put my own mark on it. So I think it's going to be great. It's been great working with her for the week, the week that I have been here. So,
give it time.
Yeah.
I'm just joking.
Looks like I've been working with her long enough. Yes. I know.
No. And there's just a lot of exciting things that come up throughout the year. And I tell you, if you think there's going to be a day where you're just going to walk in and nothing's going on, yeah. Not the case.
Not in marketing.
No. No. And not with the hospital. I mean, you know, you mentioned the outreach part of it, but you've got doctors, nurses, just other staff members who not only, you know, just go up there and have solid employment, but they're also involved in the community doing outreach or coaching or, you know, they care about what's going on. Mm-hmm. You know, these are ambassadors for the hospital.
Right.
And the same with Meadville. You know, you see folks involved in their community.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's important.
Right. Yep. I mean, and even internally, you know, like we do a lot of internal things like, you know, Go Red for Women Month is February 2nd, and that's coming up. And, you know, we do daffodil days at the hospital. You know, internally, we do all of those types of things. And we're going to have a Relay for Life team again. So we're already, you know, starting to ramp those things up. Going to have a bake sale February 11th at the hospital to help raise funds for that team. So, you know, we do a lot of things internally as well. So it's nice to get the staff involved.
Well, was it last month you brought in the chart, the impact?
Yes. Yeah.
That was very eye-opening. I mean, that's incredible.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah.
Good job.
It's fun.
Good
Thank
job.
You. Yeah.
Kelly, welcome.
Thank
back.
You. Thank you. Yeah. It's great to be home.
Yeah. What did you miss most about this area?
I think I just really miss my family most, to be honest. But it's a whole different speed here. You know, and I always said that I would come home to visit my parents, and it's kind of like time just stopped, you know.
Very slow.
Yeah, yeah. So I miss that. I miss, you know, and I miss everybody being friendly, which is strange, you know. The first day I took my kids to school, I was like, Mom, there's no cell service. What if I break down? You know, if I don't come home, like,
smoke signals will work.
In the woods, we're good.
My mom was like, someone will find you. You'll be fine. Someone will stop. They know you. It's fine. So it's a little safer here and a little slower and more friendly. So
whether you're cute or not, it'll work, right?
Yes.
You're accepted at the hospital.
That's right.
Holli, what'd you learn today?
I learned a little bit more about Kelly and that she loves to be here, which is great.
Right. Kelly, what'd you learn today?
I learned where this place is. I wasn't really sure, so it was nice. It was nice to meet you.
Best of luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks,
see ya.
Luke.